Good morning, grade 9 students. This is Mrs Moni Assy. Today is Tuesday, March 10, 2020. Our chapter today is about the science of heredity, lesson 3, patterns of inheritance. So please open your books to page 86. The objective of the lesson is to explain how most traits are inherited and to identify the several patterns of inheritance found in life. Not all traits or genes studied are controlled by two possible alleles. How is this possible? What happens in this case? Most traits are a result of complex pattern of inheritance, not simple ones such as the dominant or recessive. Knowing that the dominant and the recessive, when the dominant is available, it is stronger and it always shows. However, when the recessive is available, it is hidden or masked by the dominant allele. One of the complex pattern of inheritance is called the incomplete dominance. Incomplete dominance occurs when one allele is only partially dominant. Neither one allele is completely dominant. In this case, the outcome or the offspring takes a little from each, so they look as a combination, or the traits are simply blended and they produce a new trait or a new characteristic. Let's look at the example in page 87. There's an example about incomplete dominance that crosses two flowers, the white and the red flowers. The white flowers and the red flowers give an outcome of offspring that are pink flowers. As you notice in the Punnett square, both alleles are written in capital letters. White is written in capital and red is written in capital, and the offspring each taking one capital from the mother and one capital from the father, and the outcome becomes pink flowers. In this example in the slide, you also see that it's the same concept. Crossing two flowers that are red and white, however, the names of the letters of the colors are different from those from the book. However, the outcome is neither red nor white. It is a combination between those two. It becomes pink, or simply a blended combination between white and red. Another type of complex pattern of inheritance are called, or is, the codominance. Codominance occurs when both alleles for a gene are expressed equally. Two alleles are expressed together. Some of each trait is shown in the offspring. In the second figure in page 87, a white feathered chicken is crossed with a black feathered one. The result is neither black nor white. All the offspring have white and black feathers. Note that in the Punnett square, we write the alleles described in capital letters as with a subscript on the trait describing the trait. So we are talking about feathers here. We write F for feathers and a subscript of W for white, subscript of B for black. The offspring are shown are FB, FW, so they both have the both traits are given for the offspring. They have both the FB allele and the FW allele to appear white and black at the same time. Another type of complex patterns of inheritance are multiple alleles and polygenic alleles. In multiple alleles, some genes have multiple alleles, which means that three or more possible alleles join together to determine the trait. One organism, as we know, can only inherit two alleles, one from the father and one from the mother. So the combination of three or four alleles cannot be present. What happens in this case? In this case, only two alleles determine the trait. So if it's combined in a way, it determines a special trait, or if it's combined in another way, it determines another trait. Polygenic inheritance occurs when one or more than one gene affects the trait. The alleles of the different genes, they work together to produce these traits. For example, the height in a person is determined by many types of genes. So all these genes work together. If we're talking about the thickness of the bone, the height of the bone, the height of the neck, etc. All these joined together to give the person its height. So this is called polygenic inheritance. As a conclusion, we know that most traits are only a result of dominant or recessive alleles. However, there are many complex patterns of inheritance that may affect the traits or the characteristics of the offspring. As an assignment, please study pages 86 to 88 from the book and look at the slides below and highlight the important things on your book. Thank you.